Hello and welcome back to another episode on this channel. I am calling Sweet Jenny with the Mastermind. For some time now, I've been uploading videos to this channel without a face. And today, I have decided to add that face behind a voice. So today, I'm going to be sharing with you some bad Sigma spending habits and how I overcome those habits and save more money as a Sigma. The very first bad Sigma spending habit is their poor bargaining power. You see, most Sigmas like myself don't know how to bargain. When I go to the market, for example, and I see a product that I want, or I see a product that I've been searching for some time, I don't hesitate to buy the product, because when I approach the seller, what I think at the back of my head is how much value I'm going to get from that product, or how much satisfaction that product is going to give me, rather than think about the price, which is wrong. In order to save more money, Sigmas need to increase their bargaining power. Because when I started bargaining products, I started saving more money. And last month in particular, I was able to save 30% of my income. So one thing Sigmas need to do is they need to increase their bargaining power. And in order to increase your bargaining power, I learned that before I go to the market to buy a product or a service, I need to first of all do one, know about the product, do market research. I need to know about the pricing of that product. I find out from previous users or log into the website if the business has a website and look at the prices they are offering. If there's something I badly need or I know that I will use it for a long period of time, I prefer to always buy in bulk. So buying in bulk, you always have a huge discount that is given to you, and by that, you save more money. Nevertheless, it is not in every case that you need to buy in bulk because you want to have a good discount. But in other cases, the only thing that is going to help you is to bargain and bargain and bargain till you reach that price point that is okay for you and you know you can afford it. Next, my spending habit number two was I was basing my decision-making ability on the information I was getting from the seller, especially in the case where I had limited information about the service or product I was about to buy. I believe that people would treat me in the same way I would treat them, which means that as Sigmas, we treat people with honesty, we tell the truth, we are humble, we will approach people. What I forgot to understand was that all sellers are liars, because the seller will only tell you what you want to hear as a buyer so that he can close that sale and make a profit from it. So as a buyer, I was supposed to have background information and I had to rely or base my judgment purely on the information I had about that product or service. So if you're a Sigma and you want to buy something out there, make sure you do your background search. Know about the product, know about the pricing, because if you base your decision making only on the information you get from the sales rep, that person is bound to tell you only what you want to hear at that moment for him to close a sale. The next poor spending habit of mine was that I thought that high price meant quality. Because I lead a minimalist lifestyle, I prefer to have a few things of high quality that will last me for long before making another purchase. So because I believe that anything that had a high price was durable and will last long, which was not the case. Although we have that strong love for good things, for things that will last long, it is good to always do your research and know that the one thing at marketplace is bargaining. And bargaining is simply the influence you have on another person. So it is either you make a win in the purchase or the seller makes that win over you. And there's one thing I realize when I'm going out to the market to buy is that I make some price points. What I mean by price point in this case, in my own scenario, is that for every product I'm going to buy, I make the least amount of money I can pay for it, the average amount of money I can pay for that product, and the maximum amount of money I can pay for that product. So that at the end of the day, even if I pay the minimum price, the average price, or the maximum price, I have still saved some money. Or if I cannot still make that purchase the way I want, I look for a substitute product of the same functionality and low cost to replace what I wanted. And this has saved me more money than I thought. My problem number four was that I was always impatient in the marketplace. And an impatient buyer buys like an impulsive buyer, because at the end of the day, I end up spending more money because I did not want to talk to strangers whom I did not know. I did not want to spend a lot of time bargaining something over and over, which I knew that at the end of the day I was going to buy because it was very important to me. So by not having to waste time on it, I had to pay more. What I discovered, which boils down to the same thing, is bargain, 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 and bargain. And in the course of doing so, I realized that with bargaining, you talk less, you let the other person talk more. And then before you go to buy that particular product, make sure to research and know if there are substitute products to that one. Because once a seller knows that there are substitute products to the product he is offering or selling, he makes sure to give you at a discount price so that he can be able to make a sale and also put his competitors at bay. How did I overcome the four-part habit of mine that was taking away much of my money to be able to save 30% of my income this month and last month as well? What I did was, because I had a poor bargaining power and I knew that was a fault, I did the following things. First, I chose somebody that has more bargaining skills than I to do my buying for me. And secondly, I decided to buy online and from supermarkets, because there you had the advantage of fixed prices, low cost, and then you had the freedom of selection, the freedom of choice, and then there was a possibility to easily navigate different websites to sample the different prices in order to make a choice. Though buying online or supermarket saved me the trouble of the face-to-face contact with people I did not know, the overwhelming bargaining process, online purchasing and buying also have risks that you need to watch out for. First, the risk of fraud. Buying from scam website, thinking that you're buying from the right website. So you need to check carefully and double check before you pay your price. There could be delays, right? There could be delays in the shipping process. And then you need to beware of hidden cost, because some of these websites or supermarkets with their delivery services, they don't actually give you the full cost of how much you need to spend now. That said, how was I able to use my planning abilities to make more money or to save 30% in a month? First, what I did was I followed this rule I call making an exhaustive list of wants and needs. I borrowed this concept from David Allen's book, Getting Things Done. In his book, he says that if you want to get things done, the very first thing you need to do is you need to remove those ideas from your head and put them on paper. After you put them on paper, you categorize the ideas based on how much time each needs to get accomplished. So what I did was write all of my wants and needs for that month, or the things that I needed. And when I wrote them, I arranged them in order and I categorized them in order of cost and how important they were to me. The next thing is I did a 30 days expenditure plan. Therefore, what I do is my expenditure plan for this month was drawn 30 days ago. Therefore, by doing a plan 30 days ago, you give room for you to be able to tell between the essential needs and wants. Because over time, your essential needs become more and more obvious to you, because you see the needs as time goes by. But for your wants, the more time you take to satisfy that want, the lesser that desire to satisfy it. I don't know if you're getting what I'm saying. So if you draw a 30 days plan, you will feel that pressure to have that thing because you see its lack every day in your life. That your want, when you draw a 30 days plan, the longer the days, the lesser you want to provide for that one. I hope you get it. Now, the next thing I did was I executed all the ideas on my list in order of preference based on necessity and cost for me to save more money. After that, I also did a contingency scale of preference plan, which is I get the items on this scale of preference and I take item number one. I look at its alternatives in the market. If the alternatives are better than it, and the price too is lower to allow me to save more money, I strike that one off and I take that on the contingency scale of preference. So I took my scale of preference and I did a complementary or a contingency scale of preference with the same production and their alternatives, looking at cost, functionality, and how effective they could be. So with those, I intersect, and at the end of the day, I saw that I saved more just on doing it. It takes time. And you know, us Sigmas, we have that time we put into planning. So it's better to do something that takes you more time and helps you save more money. So that was just all I had for you today. Though for a start, I don't really feel comfortable talking into the camera. Remember, Sigmas are always up to the task, no matter what it takes. So see you in the next video.